Matthew, you have written a paper on adolescence and joy where you not only lifted up those things which are foundations of joy, those things which enhance joy, those things which elicit joy in adolescence, but those things that are a threat to joy. And one of the great threats to human well-being, to flourishing, to our faith, to joy is what you call scientism. Help us understand what you mean by scientism, how it's a threat, and what a youth ministry can do to equip young people to deal with it.
Yeah, so scientism is this idea that kind of science is the ultimate arbiter of truth and objective value. So if something that we can't measure through science, i.e. our sensory capacities, then it but just must not exist. And so things like souls just can't exist because we can't measure them with our sensory capacities, that science has nothing to say on the matter. And then they make the further claim that these things just must not exist. And so this has led to our kind of societal valuing of scientism almost as a kind of religion, right? Because there's obvious problems with scientism. It could be that there's something wrong with our sensory capacities and that we don't perceive all of reality or even reality the way it is. And certainly evolutionary psychology has revealed that to us, that we have problems with our sensory capacities. The second is, it has nothing to say about other capacities we might have. And philosophers like Bill Alston and Alvin Plantinga have said that maybe if God does exist, he would have given us these spiritual capacities, like sensory capacities, that allow me to say, I know that chair is over there. Maybe I have spiritual capacities that says, I know that God exists and that he's speaking to me right now. So the problems of scientism are obvious, and it's been set up in our society as almost like a kind of religion. And so people just say, I believe science. And so the problem is with this physicalist and biological reductionist view of human nature, then just what emerges is what Viktor Frankl calls the existential vacuum. It's this pervasive nihilism that suggests that there's no kind of objective truth, deeper meaning to human lives. And so the problem with this is that then if you're looking for a framework to know how to act, really the only thing you're left with is natural inclination. And indeed, that's what we find. And there's some major problems with this for adolescents. One is that the adolescent reward and emotional networks are very, very far from being fully developed. It's only in kind of 25 to 30 years old that they're developed. And indeed, we find that with individuals who are older than 30, their reward networks are much more activated when they kind of gamble or there's an expectation of reward and they're risking something. Whereas with adolescents, it's a much lower response in the reward system. And so psychologists have suggested that this probably is why adolescents engage in such risky behavior and such stimulation is because their reward network is at a lower threshold, they need more of it to experience things. And so this problem with accepting natural inclinations for your framework beyond the fact that our natural inclinations can never fulfill us, which is the reason why people keep on this, what's known as the hedonic treadmill, you know, pursuing goal after goal after goal after goal, never satisfied, always trying to accumulate more material stuff, is particularly bad in adolescence because there's so much stimulation you can seek, particularly in our society now with social media everywhere. And also, because their reward network is so underdeveloped, they just keep needing more of it. And so we need to push back against this idea of scientism, biological reductionism, say, you know, maybe science isn't the ultimate arbiter of truth. Here's some reasons why. And maybe you should hold it open that we aren't just a bundle of drives or you know, maybe something like deeper meaning and truth to human life does exist. And I think that's what's going to create the opportunities for adolescents to even start asking the questions of what would joy and what would a meaningful life look like, instead of just saying, oh, I'm going to pursue drive reduction because that's the only thing that there is.